and begin.
I need someone to show me my place in all this.
Welcome back to LEGO Star Wars. Here's the part of the LEGO Star Wars game where we just try to shotgun it to the Luke Skywalker drinking blue titty milk. Now, you'll notice I use the word shotgun incorrectly. I don't know how this happened, but I've been doing it for most of my life. Really, the word should be, we're going to rush. We're gonna quickly go to that part. Speed run. We're gonna slingshot our way. We're gonna book it. Thank you. Gun it. Maybe it's because the word is gun it, and I've been using shotgun in place of that. That's weird. So we were talking about a moment ago how World of Warcraft possibly ruined lives. And I think any video game where you dedicate a large amount of time, I would say, as much as that seems to be true, perhaps gacha games have ruined more lives. Eh, we don't need this. So, hear me out. World of Warcraft is a game you can get lost in. Sure, someone probably died playing it and sitting at the computer. But there's a good chance that gacha games have drained people's wallets for all they were worth. And remember, for as much as a game might be destructive to some, it might be very helpful for others. So, but yeah, to answer that question plainly and bluntly, it seems like World of Warcraft probably got a lot of people out of real world. And I think going further from that, like I said, the gacha stuff probably bankrupt a lot of people. What else? Oh yeah, public PSA. If you see a turtle on the street, please remember to, if a turtle is upside down on the street, place it, back the right way up in the way it was facing so that it can continue crossing the street. Don't bring it back to where it started, otherwise it's just going to cross the road again. So, save a turtle. Get them to their destination. Someone said fucking chuck it. No! Yes! Vinny, did you see the new Saul Goodman? I don't want to spoil it even by giving you my reaction to the episode, so I'm going to be very vague here, because currently that is like the highest rated episode of the show, and I think maybe it was the best, perhaps, or like in the top five. It was amazing, and fucked me right up, so I guess that's as much as I can say. But yeah, Saul is just cementing itself as being as good as Breaking Bad, if not better. I don't know. I can't tell you yet, but man, do I love that show. Holy fuck. Excited for the new Stranger Things. Nope!
Oz is a bit of an acquired taste, so let me do the talking.
Well, A, my Netflix is gone.
Any of it.
Let us continue the story, and then I will talk
Solo.
More.
Oh, boy.
Hey, Oz!
I assume you need something.
I need you to get this droid to Leia.
No. You've been running from this fight for too long.
Please, we need your help.
It's here that she finds a literal mystery box. And a bunch of flashbacks that ultimately mean nothing by the time we get to episode 9.
It's nothing. I'm just gonna take a look around.
Come on, Mom. boss. What's it gonna take?
I could watch Stranger Things. It wouldn't be difficult to find it. It's just, you know, no rush. The show has only, for me, gotten less and less interesting as time has gone on.
Well, I don't have it anymore.
It's going on your path.
Are they gonna play that song that J.J. Abrams wrote? No, it's not Jizz in Maz Kanata's castle. Oh god, it's Jizz!
So tell me about the girl.
Well, what I can tell you is...
Guys, she's standing right there.
Oh, Maz. That big statue outside is that new?
Yeah! Where'd you take that ancient rat?
The Bobcat Goldthwait? Is there an audio delay for anyone else? Is there? Because, just double check. Because I fixed my OBS, I think. Twitch does that sometimes? Okay. There might be a slight delay, but that's probably always going to be the case with OBS. It's like a few milliseconds. I mean, it's almost not even worth trying to offset. I can do minus 100. That's fine. Now it's probably just a little bit better. I'll just leave it at a default minus 100 for everything from now on. That should be good. I can't. Oh my god! They did the famous Obi-Wan Kenobi scream! No lines for Obi-Wan Kenobi, just him screaming. Oh, that is wonderful. Woo! Remind me never to do that again. Someone said, I don't get it. In A New Hope, the special editions, they had it so that when Obi-Wan scares the sand people, he makes a big woo sound, which was that sound, and it's like, why is this... what the fuck? It was so, like, over the top. What was it before? I don't even remember. Chat, what was it before? Was it just less of a scream? Why did George change it? I don't know. Vinny, there's a vid. Okay. Obi-Wan scream. Here's the comparison. Okay, here's the theatrical scream. So remember, this is when the Jawas are, Luke is unconscious. Jawas are taking stuff out of Luke's speeder. So that was the original, okay? The original was this. So, the sand people, not Jawas. I'm sorry, yeah, not the Jawas. What am I saying? It's the, Tusken Raiders. So somehow Obi-Wan used the Force to make that noise. Now here's the Blu-ray version. I wonder if this is gonna get claimed. I mean... I'm not convinced that Obi-Wan could make that original noise either. But that one is just, like, next level stupid. Vinny, Disney is going to DMCA the stream. They could. Yeah, I think they have enough audio that they probably could. The first one is plausible because it could be like a horn or something. The second one is just silly. Yeah. I mean, the first one actually does sound like, the end of it sounds like kind of like a creature. At least. Audio recording devices exist. In the Star Wars universe? No one even has a cell phone in Star Wars. Ah yes, Maz Kanata's treasure chest.
Saber was Luke's, and his father's before him, and now it calls to you.
How'd you get it?
I don't want any part of this.
How'd you get it? Where'd you get it? A story for another time. Did you know this lightsaber has killed younglings?
The First Order, they've done it.
That's just sad.
Where's Rey?
Where'd you get that?
Take it. Find your friend. Those beasts. They're here.
Rey! Where is she?
So many possibilities for Finn. So many interesting story angles that could have been explored. Oh, sorry. He just yells a lot, and then, like, when he wakes up from comas, he screams the word Rey. I guess we get to fight traitor. That was a fun meme for a while, remember that?
Traitor!
Friend of yours?
Not exactly.
Not gonna let us go.
This should have been
hello.
Phasma. They had Phasma, they like made Phasma into this big deal. Just because she had cool armor, and they got Gwendolyn Christie to play the role, and then they did, like, nothing with her. She just became a joke. What a shame. I had the figurine! I bought the Phasma figurine! I don't know why, I was too old! They got me. Yeah, I spent money on a movie ticket and then a Captain Phasma figurine. They got me. I think the lightsaber is gone. Yeah, the lightsaber. Soy impulse purchases. Fuck you, chat member. Get out of here. Yes, yeah, like, what are you speaking, Spanish, chat member?
The girl I've heard so much about. The map. You've seen it. Pull the division out. Forget the droid. We have what we need.
Kill the past by building a new drill storm.
He took her. Did you see that? He took her! She's gone!
Yeah, yeah, I know. Ooh. You've changed your hair.
Same jacket.
No, new jacket. I saw him. Leia, I saw her son. He was here.
We're heading back to the base on Dakar. We can catch up there.
Lightsaber's back. I know. No, it's sad because there was never really the reunion with the three of them. But here's something that maybe many of us didn't know about Star Wars. Did you know that none of this is actually real? Which, obviously, by me saying that, it's totally okay that they dropped the ball on so many obvious things that would have been really cool for fans. Maybe the Star Wars did happen a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. I don't know, actually. Never mind. I can't prove the non-existence of Star Wars, just as much as I can't prove that Jar Jar Binks didn't control the entirety of the events of all the movies. I can't prove that Jar Jar Binks didn't give Dexter Jetster a hand jammy under the 50s diner table.
Real.
It's real.
So, I watched the George Carlin documentary, and it was mostly amazing. George Carlin just wanted to talk a little bit about it because I realized watching that documentary how important that comedy was to my thinking growing up, and like not just kind of believing everything that they said in Catholic school or on the TV or whatever. Like, just kind of the way Carlin's comedy made me think about life, which I'm not saying is better or worse than anyone else's, but I appreciate it as I get older. I'm like, I'm glad I got to see that dude's comedy specials at, like, the perfect age. I do think he was one of the best. And, it is funny how much people are posting his stuff these days. And, like, not just to post his stuff because he was really, really good as a comedian, but because, you know, people post his stuff to try to, like, prove a political opinion of theirs. But the thing is, you could then post a response with a George Carlin comedy bit that would be opposite that and piss off the original chat member. Or person. I don't know why I called a person a chat member. But that's the kind of comedian he was. I mean, it was just kind of everything. And, but he's gotten a lot more popular in recent years with people posting his stuff. So the documentary is well-timed, and I think he really was great. It's one of those things where it's like, how do you miss someone you've never met? but it would have been nice to just hear his thoughts on things, you know? Speaking of things, it was especially good for me to watch that today, considering what the hell's going on when you just feel so... I mean, especially the end of the documentary goes into his, like, kind of nihilism, which he wasn't really nihilistic. I think it kind of touches on he had a big heart and he just couldn't take how fucked up people were and how fucked up things were on the planet, etc., etc. And so he became much more like, I like to see people die! And it became a bit of his. Just the absurdity and tragedy of life. And, especially today, it was like, you just feel like, holy fuck. How is things this bad? How are things this fucked up and stupid? And, it just knocks the wind out of your sails. So, yeah, watching that Carlin documentary was actually really good. And it helped me realize, like, how he handled it, what he did with his work, how honest he was about what he thought about things, how he viewed things and then translated it into comedy. And I think ultimately he did it to try to do some good on this planet. And so that was a nice thing to see on a day where I was feeling a little down. So, yeah, I guess that's really all I wanted to say about that. It's a good documentary, I recommend it. If you don't know George Carlin's work, you may enjoy watching it. And, that's about it. He was also the voice of the Shining Time Station conductor. So he went from, I like to watch massive amounts of people die.
I woke up, no ship, no you, no nothing.
To, hey kids, it's me, the train conductor.
Well, we should go speak with the general. She's gonna want to talk to you. Come on, BB-8.
But that's also as he got older, too, when he lost his wife and, you know, he was aging and seeing tragedy in the world and things were just getting stupider and worse. So it's not hard to see why he would incorporate that into his comedy. Anyway, I know you're here for the funnies. I just wanted a couple minutes of your time. And, there you go. No, Ringo Starr was the other train conductor.
You must not have recognized me on the way in due to my stylish red arm. There's actually an interesting story. Who are you calling self-indulgent?
That's not 3PO. He's got a red arm.
General, I regret to inform you, but this map recovered from BB-8 is only partially complete.
Can't believe I was so foolish to think I could find Luke and bring him home.
The scan data from Snap's reconnaissance flight confirms Finn's report. This was the Death Star.
Duke Leto?
And this is Starkiller Base, the weapon that destroyed the Hosnian system. Hmm? hang on. This thing's 4K.
The First Order. They're charging the weapon again now. Our system is the next target.
Okay, how do we blow it up?
That base has to have some kind of thermal oscillator.
They have defensive shields that our ships cannot penetrate.
I can disable their shields. But I have to be there on the planet. We'll get you there.
Okay. Vinny, George Carlin is great, but did you see Dane Cook?
Kidding me? No way. Not happening.
Whoa, were you glitching? Stouffer's French bread pizza. That is the only bit I remember from Dane Cook. That and every, like, 6 months, a chat member shows up and is like, Vinny, you sound like Dane Cook. I'm like, Stouffer's French bread pizza? I still don't understand how the third Death Star is supposed to work. Well, it shoots planets from various solar systems away with a laser that travels faster than the speed of light by many, many, many factors.
The flooding tunnel is over that ridge.
It sucks sun energy and shoots a Death Star beam.
Where am I?
You're my guest. I know you've seen the map, and now you'll give it to me.
I'm not giving you anything.
Give me the map!
Never.
Okay, he sounded a lot better with the helmet distortion.
The scavenger resisted you.
She is strong with the force.
Then the resistance must be destroyed before they get to Skywalker. Prepare the weapon.
Supreme Leader, I can get the map from the girl.
Bring her to me.
You will remove these restraints and leave this cell with the door open.
I will remove these restraints and leave this cell with the door open.
In retrospect, it makes so much sense because she's Palpy's granddaughter. The fuck?
The longer we're here, the less luck we're gonna have. The shields.
I have an idea about that.
Hey!
Intruders!
Rebels have infiltrated the base. Eliminate them immediately. Don't tell me we have to come down there myself.
Alright, big deal. Now what?
The Basma won't be able to resist coming down and dealing with us herself. And that's when we make her lower the shield.
And we throw her in the garbage.
You're all useless. Must I always take matters into my own hands?
What was your job when you were based here?
Sanitation.
Sanitation?
Confirmed, Finn was based. These... Chewbacca does not get enough love. Chewbacca should be able to just, like, absolutely fucking decimate a stormtrooper with one choke slam. Did you hear about the Starkiller Battle Pass? Yeah, they had it for all the stormtroopers. You kill enough resistance members or rebels or whatever the fuck they called them in this movie, and you start leveling up your paycheck. Speaking of Battle Pass, did anyone see me play that multiverse game? Which, not only did it have like a large amount of battle pass unlockables, some of them were actually affecting the gameplay. and the menus look like Fortnite.
Ray? Ray! She's safe!
Atta girl.
I know it's free to play, but it's just, like... It's just... Like, it's just, things are getting so homogenized. The game itself was not terrible, even if it lacked something I couldn't put my finger on it. Maybe it was the sluggish combat. Sluggish-ish.
Is this door unlocked?
There's no way through, sir!
Did I detect a pun, Private?
Free-to-play doesn't necessarily mean bad, it's just when the whole industry is going towards a certain model. And things start to look the same in the UI, the menus, and the battle passes, and like... You know, how long it takes to unlock something. The game itself wasn't terrible. But it didn't really do anything particularly new. Just kind of another of that type of game. But, you know, some people are probably gonna really like it and fall down the rabbit hole of that game's battle hole. Battle Pass didn't have perks, only cosmetics. Oh. So I guess in order to unlock perks, you have to just play a lot of the game. Chocobo Racing is apparently backpedaling its microtransactions. Really? Okay, if it happens, I'll see it when I believe it, A, but B, if that's true, I'd be very curious to see what they're gonna do with it. Man, these stormtroopers take a lot of hits. Did you hear about Seth Green's monkey getting stolen? No, but I heard that Top Hat Monkey Goes West got stolen. The headline of the news is all I'm aware of, and it sounded incredible. It was like... Oh my god, what was it? It was, can someone get me the exact headline? I want to read it out loud.
I will deal with you myself, then. Cowards!
The show was awful. Someone stole Seth Green's bored ape, which was supposed to star in his new show. That wasn't the exact headline, but close enough. Was it an Ape Escape video game adaptation, perhaps?
Come out, wherever you are.
We're going to need that power core if there's any chance of us capturing Phasma.
Seth Green's Bored Ape NFT, which was set to star in his own animated show, was stolen through a phishing scam. Green no longer owns the commercial rights to the NFT, and thus the show cannot move forward. Oh, I just ugly snorted. Oh, yeah, that's a nice thing that is so funny, and what the fuck does life even anymore?
She takes one step on this, and she'll be in for the shock of her life. It worked! Not so tough now, are you, Phasma?
Less Brody, more capture. We need that shield down.
Get down here. Let me show you how to deal with intruders.
Wait, what? That bonk was not good enough?
Yeah.
We need a Jedi.
Not from a Jedi.
Never mind. I'll find Plasma, don't worry.
We ought to use that power core again. Let's go get it.
I'm sorry, what the fuck is happening here? Build this device.
I'd like to see her brush this one off.
Yeah.
Let's get her to the system control room. We can shut down the shield from in there.
They're making her as much of a joke
I won't make
in the game as she was in the movie. Poor Gwendolyn Christie, between Game of Thrones flopping at the end there and this, and the Star War, you know.
Open the door, now.
I would argue that her character in Game of Thrones was one of the few that didn't get, like, completely, like, ass savaged. Seriously. Like, she was actually. She retained some level of respect. She still felt like her character by the end of the show. Oh yeah, well with the Jamie stuff, yeah, that got kind of weird. But I guess it made at least some level of sense. She fared better than most, let's put it that way.
Lower the shields.
You're making a big mistake.
What do we do with her?
Damn it!
Garbage chute? Trash compactor?
Yeah, there is.
Huh?
Looney Tunes noises.
Finn, what are you doing here?
Jamie!
Hug later.
Danger, Will Robinson, danger.
That shields it down! Almost in range. Hit the target dead center as many runs as we can get.
Jamie!
Ah, direct hit. But no damage.
Those are the things that you load into the guns in Lego.
A bag full of explosives. Let's use it.
If you're going to get inside, I need to find the junction box.
Huh. Girl knows her stuff.
So wait, is there actually like a free play segment on the Starkiller base where you could do quests and stuff? Oh, Ringo launched a collection. Ringo Starr has launched a collection of NFTs, which will be virtual in a little museum. Of course I'll do it. I know what an NFT is, absolutely. How much do I have to do? You just have to do a little promo, Ringo, that's it. Alright. Just read the words here on this card in front of a green screen and we'll get your baby like on a virtual collection, and in about 2 years you'll make 85 times how much you spent. Alright, sounds good to me. No, Ringo, trust me, all the hip new musicians are doing it. You want to be hip and cool still, right? I guess so.
Let's make a move. We need to be ready at the door once Ray gets it open. Atta girl. Are you trying to blow us up? Hey, when I dropped them, we weren't sneaking into a first order base. And the Falcon was fine in the end. Come on, we got a job to do. Walkway's out. We could just dump the charge here. Ever the perfectionist. Fine. Then find us a way across.
Must have been the wind. I see shiny thing, I press the shiny thing. Hey, what's that smell?
Pal, that's a Wookiee in heat. No, he's just hot.
So much for stealth. Okay, it was a real boring conversation anyway. Oh yeah, Chewie has children. He's got Lumpy, he's got Itchy, he's got Scratchy, Pulpy. Screwbaka. Did you know that Han Solo had a Wookiee before he had Chewbacca?
Fire!
He
fire,
did.
Fire.
Her name was Dulana. Alright, so maybe that book isn't canon anymore, but that's not gonna stop me from remembering Dulana. Where is this joke from? No, I'm serious, it was a book. He had a Wookiee. Chewbacca wasn't his first.
Rufus, fire!
Are you saying that Chewbacca was the replacement dog? Yes. I'm not answering that question, chat member. You know who you are. Did you know that Darth Vader's suit has voodoo hide in it? It also had a fleshlight. Oh, cool, okay. Now, Palpatine wouldn't grant Vader such luxuries, you know?
Is that all of them? Let's get out of here.
You know what was in Darth Vader's suit? Like, pain devices. So that Vader was just always angry. Like, he put, like, devices that just poked Vader with needles. Like sand. Yeah. Yeah, it was just filled with sand, correct.
Ben!
Han Solo.
My son.
Here we go.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, it wasn't as gruesome as the movie.
Hit the target hard. Give it everything you got.
I'm getting inside that oscillator just yet.
Let's bend down their defenses. Red Squadron, Blue Squadron, do your thing.
This is cool, at least.
They have a lot of firepower.
Again, just makes me really want that Rogue Squadron remake, or sequel. Or the lost game that never actually came out. Like, we got all this lost media lately. We got Duke Nukem Forever, for God's sake. And yet, there is a Rogue Squadron game that was made for the Wii that was, like, finished. And then it was canceled after it was finished. Did you play, were you interested in Squadrons? Squadrons was okay. I like the more arcadey style. Maybe not as arcadey as this. But Squadrons was fun. I played it with a flight stick, which was kind of neat-ish. Like, I liked it, but it didn't hold my attention for the whole game, but I still ended up playing through it and enjoying a lot of it. So yeah, more like that, but I would prefer the Rogue Squadron stuff.
The last of their cannons are
but also, those games weren't tremendously long.
Is anyone seeing these torpedoes lying around?
The extras are what made that game have replay value, like that series.
By making a new Death Star trench run.
I love me a trench run. Watch out, you're getting hit.
thought that was R2 screaming.
The Falcon's this way.
Oh, that was so perfectly timed. I was looking for the pipe hit, and I found that at the exact right moment.
Come and get it.
No one can stand in my way. Not Han, not you.
Second time holding a lightsaber, and I'm fighting Kylo Ren. Steep learning curve.
Yes, tell me about it. But that's okay. When the movie came out, everyone was like, no, the reason they can win is because Kylo Ren was hit with the crossbow, and he was bleeding, and he's injured. Which, actually, that's actually kind of fair. I'll buy it.
He wants us to follow him.
He's probably a trap, but we can't let him get away.
My name is Kylo Morbius, and I am an engineer on the Death Star. I need a backup transfusion. In order to save my life from becoming a Sith Lord.
I got microphone fuzz in my mouth.
What is that?
Wow. I got the foam. Okay, we're good.
It's Morbin time.
I see his footprints. He went this way.
Again, they did a very good job recreating all the scenes from the movies. I'm stuck. Still stuck. Still stuck. Can't attack, can't jump, can't get out of here.
A scavenger and a traitor. You two are pathetic.
Scavenger and traitor.
I could have done the voice for Kylo Ren.
We can't let him get away with what he's done.
A scavenger and a traitor. A vampire.
You're a monster.
It's just us now. Han Solo can't save you.
Well, I will say this, he does sound more like Han Solo's son now.
You won't win. You can't.
Watch me.
Ben!
Use that palp strength that was planned from the beginning. Wait, why does Finn have another lightsaber? What the fuck? What the fuck? There wasn't supposed to be another lightsaber. Wow, this game is glitchy. It was a blaster saber. I remember when people were analyzing the footage of the fight from this movie and saying that Rey was Palpatine's granddaughter because the way she thrust her lightsaber.
We have to stop him. Let's just find a way.
Because she would do the thrusts. You see that thrust? Like, no one else in Star Wars uses the thrust, so it must be Palpatine's granddaughter. Boy, those people were fucking stupid. And then they were right. Turns out I was the stupid. Yeah, the Rey's theme musically had the leitmotif. And people were like, hey, Rey's theme could be either, like, light or dark. And I think that was, like, JJ was like, well, we don't know what we're gonna do with her. So, you know, if you could possibly... I don't know, if you could make the theme have, like, hints of the dark side in it. That way, you know, we go, dark Rey, we could use it. And, you know, it looked like we planned it all along. If you could do that, John Williams, that would be great. John Williams like, all right, can someone get this guy out of my face? Yeah, I'll do it. Just leave me alone, JJ Abrams. Did literally anybody say that? Oh yeah, I was there. I was also there when George Lucas was like, I don't care, put him in a teddy bear suit. We're gonna have teddy bears on the moon. Whatever. Another Death Star and there's teddy bears.
Go on, get him.
Engaging target. Yeah, good camera. Well, I originally wrote Return of the Jedi so that it would be a Wookiee planet, and a bunch of Wookiees would be, like, eating big haunches of meat and destroying stormtroopers, but we couldn't find enough tall people. And it turns out that making Wookiee costumes was at least double expensive because of how tall they are. So I said, whatever, it's teddy bears, I don't care, just get a bunch of little people. George, that's a little weird that you would say it like that. Whatever. Get him some work. George, that's very insensitive. It's a good thing George Lucas said it, not me. But no, George Lucas loved to put little dudes in suits. I don't know. That was a thing in the whole trilogy, the whole series. To be fair, though, we got Warwick Davis out of it, and Warwick Davis is wonderful. I love Warwick Davis. That dude is fantastic. Sorry, Warwick. He was in Willow. He was in some other stuff. Leprechaun in the Hood. Hell yeah. Idiot Abroad. Yeah. Got to hang out with world famous Carl Pilkington.
You need a teacher. I can show you the ways of the Force.
Okay. You big bully. Someone said, I still think all Star Wars media is brainless fun. I love that. The fandom should calm their teats. It's both. much like those games I was talking about earlier, people have intense emotional connections to this material, and I do as well. But it is fun. You can treat it however you want. Poor Chewie. Chewie just wanted a medal. It's gotten into him. Chewie just lost his best friend. You notice that?
BB-8, it is very doubtful Arthur will have the rest of the map in his backup data.
Did you notice that Han Solo is dead? Where's the hero's funeral for Han Solo? Poor Chewie has to just, like, deal with it. It's alright, we'll give him a medal later.
Have some much needed good news.
Show me.
Oh yeah, Harrison Ford wanted Han Solo dead since Empire Strikes Back, so.
Luke. I'll go. I'll take Chewie and the Falcon. I'll go find Luke.
I feel secure when I eat the salad. Good to know Harrison Ford is done with the franchise. I mean, he was done with it. He felt like his character served his purpose in Empire. And to be fair, he did. And he felt like, you know, he should sacrifice himself for the other characters. And I think, you know, that would have been fine. As a kid, I didn't want Han Solo to die, so I was, like, relieved that Lucas was like, no. But as an adult now, I'm like, well, yeah, in Return of the Jedi, he's the MacGuffin for the first half of the movie, and then the second half, he stands in front of a door. So... Oh, wait, we're taking the Falcon. So this is the sound a sneeze makes. His method of torture for Lucas was to hold him down. Tie him down and have someone read the script over and over again since he hated the dialogue so much. Yeah, Harrison Ford has gone on record saying... He was like,
you can write this shit, but you can't say it.
The name of this planet is the Sneeze, chat members. That was the joke. I never said I was funny. What would you say your favorite Star Wars game is? Rogue Squadron 2. Probably, but I also like Jedi Outcast. When is Episode 1 Racer? Maybe. Jedi Fallen Order was good. I know I've been talking about that game a lot lately, but I liked it. The Ajita associated with this island. Oh, that's why it's called Ajita 2. It's like Ajita 2. It's like double the Ajita. Twice the pride, double the fall. Where are the Pogs? P-A-W-G-S. Why'd you spell it like that, Chet member? Chet member, why did you spell it like that?
Luke Skywalker.
There they are. Aw, no helicopter shot.
Time for some blue milk.
Let's bust out them Star Wars opinions. It's Last Jedi time.
Scoop!
The First Order reigns, having decimated the peaceful Republic. Supreme Leader Snoke now deploys the merciless legions to seize military control of the galaxy. Only General Leia Organa's band of resistance fighters stand against the rising tyranny. Certain that Jedi Master Luke Skywalker will return and restore a spark of hope to the fight, but the resistance has been exposed. As the First Order speeds toward the rebel base, the brave heroes mount a desperate escape. All right, now listen, it's time for a low-speed outer space chase. I don't know how the physics of this chase worked. Oh. General Hugs, your mother is calling you.
Happy Beeps here, buddy. Come on. We pulled crazier stunts than this. Oh, happy Beeps. BB-8, what did I just say about happy Beeps?
Did you say happy feet? Say what you will about this movie, there are some awesome visual shots in it. Yeah, there was an attempt at some cool ideas. I don't think they all... Many of them were terrible ideas, I think, but some of the movie looked really, really good.
Huh? Urgent communique, sir. From Poe Dameron of the Republic Fleet. It's a very good likeness. How is your
dude, Ryan Johnson directed the Fly episode of Breaking Bad and Ozymandias.
He's going for the Dreadnought.
So, I mean...
All right, take it up, cannons now. Tally, start your approach.
Copy that.
Man, they really went wild with the cannons on this thing, huh?
Again, they keep giving these, like, good visual directors writing. Like, full control. Again, JJ...
I drew it on a white paper as well. Here it comes, the parade!
Oh my god. Just take the pen away from JJ. And then they were like, for the third movie, let's give it to Chris Terrio, you know, the dude from Staten Island that ruined Batman versus Superman. That's the guy for the job to wrap up all of Star Wars. Oh yeah, he's from Staten Island. Joe, our Red Vox bassist and producer, knew him personally. I don't think he had anything specifically bad to say about him, but it's just funny. Staten Islanders ruin everything. We Staten Islanders ruin everything.
Evacuate
Installation almost complete. Just a little while longer.
Yeah.
Get your squad back here so we can get out of this place.
No, General, we can do this. We have the chance to take out a dreadnought.
Disengage now.
Oh, this That's whole subplot. Jesus.
Connection. Gotta go. Squadron,
now they're gonna drop bombs in space with no gravity,
bombers,
I guess.
Keep that tight formation. Fighters, protect the bombers. It's not every day we get a shot at a dreadnought. So let's make
They're magnetic.
Count.
They're magnetic. You don't understand. They're magnets. Just admit, it looked cool, and they filmed it because it looked cool. Made no sense whatsoever, but they were doing an homage to the World War II bombers. Like the World War II movies, where they'd open the bombs from the bottom of the thing. But, you know.
Whoa! You see that, BB-8?
A lot of Star Wars was actually, the original A New Hope was cut to World War II footage. Of like dogfights and stuff, because that's the kind of visual language that George Lucas wanted, like that kind of pacing. Some of those World War II movies.
We have to protect that last bomber. It's our only hope.
I mean, at least this is some pretty decent Rogue Squadron light gameplay. I'm enjoying this. Oops. Oh, right. Yeah. Torpedoes are limited and you have to kill TIE fighters to get them. Brilliant.
Paige, we're over the target. Why are your bay doors open?
At the time Star Wars released, World War II ended only 32 years prior. Shit's crazy to think about. Yeah, that is actually pretty fucking insane. Do it! See, again, like, it's dropping the bombs, whereas Y-Wings and TIE Bombers, if I'm not mistaken, they would just shoot the bombs forward?
They can't get away, Supreme Leader.
I guess it depends on the game.
We have them tied on the end of a string.
The They're over a planet.
Take that ridiculous
yeah, but Dave, if you're floating outside the International Space Station, you're not, like, zooming into the planet at that speed.
In a mask.
Just saying.
Prepare my ship.
Prepare my shuttle. He's swole, he's wide. We got it.
Well done, pal.
Ben naked leaking bag? What?
Star Wars has pretty loose interpretation of physics to begin with. Fair enough. You know what? I'm gonna drop it. I don't know what I'm talking about. But it looks cool. It makes no sense as far as I'm concerned, but I don't know what I'm talking about. Fucking magnets, how do they work? I don't know. This is not a hill I'm dying on. I don't...
Where's Ray?
Hey, one thing at a time, buddy. Let's get you dressed first. We'll find you a jacket and some pants. There's gotta be a closet around here, or something.
Vinny, Star Wars had Goongas. That's true. And a little dude named Watto who floated around on little wings. I mean, even Star Trek, which I think historically Star Trek has been much more attentive to details when it comes to science and physics. Even Star Trek invents shit to make it look cool. I still don't know what Leia's strategy here was. Leave and let the Dreadnought follow them. Or why not tell Poe the plan from the beginning? I'm sure there are many, 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 many people and video essays that could deconstruct some of the more bizarre elements of this movie's plot way more eloquently than I could. I'm just gonna say that I don't know what's happening or why most of the time. But this movie was real fun to look at in the movie theater when people were cheering the very first night it opened. And that, like, magic of a new Star Wars movie and not thinking too hard about it. And everybody clapping and yelling and, you know.
Come on, let's get
wow, there was some cool stuff to look at. I was really, like, I was like, yeah, this movie's pretty good. I described it as having both the best and worst aspects of Star Wars. I think. Something like that. But these days, I think I just, like I said, I soured myself to it because I think I thought about it too hard.
Who took it all?
Tell me. People have a habit of borrowing and not returning here. If you look around the ship, I'm sure you'll find some.
At least there's blue titty milk.
It says here that the last jacket went out to a P. Dameron. Don't think I know that.
P? But for as much as, like, I think this movie, for me, was weird because it kind of worked the first night. But Rise of Skywalker was so incredibly transparent about, like, do not think, just look.
That should do it.
The pacing of that movie was so out of control, insane, that I knew it was pulling a dirty trick on me from the beginning. And I was just sitting in the movie theater like, I hurt. My head hurts.
Well, I'm dressed. So where next?
All right. We've got to go back to the bridge for a debriefing. We'll get you all caught up while we're there.
And how could I not talk about the sequel trilogy yet again for the 5,000th time while playing the Lego sequel trilogy? Ugh.
They've tracked us through light speed.
That's impossible.
Follow my lead. Huh?
It's a trap! This was... People were laughing in my theater.
So, who's in charge?
Next in command is Vice Admiral Holder.
Oh, God.
Thank you, Commander.
What's our plan?
Stick to your post. Mm-hmm. And follow my orders. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Okay.
What are you doing here?
Just doing some checks.
Checking the escape pod.
That's how you inspire trust in your subordinates.
No! This fleet is doomed. I need to warn my friend Ray. If she comes back to it, she's doomed too.
I'm turning you in for desertion.
Running away. I need to get to my friend and...
All right, well, this subplot has just come to an abrupt end. I'm sorry, actually, is there something happening or supposed to happen? Did I just miss, like, a bunch of dialogue? Someone said everybody does that. Also, you know, for whatever potential they ruined with Finn, I think Kelly Marie Tran did the best job she could with this character, which they tried to do something with in this movie, but then they gave them this bizarre casino subplot. And then she was kind of like Finn's love interest, maybe, but he also loved Rey, but then in the next movie, forget about it. She doesn't exist. Don't worry about it.
The only way to ensure everyone is training with their blaster.
You got that look on your face.
Like,
tell me.
Why make a new character? Why start a whole new thread and then just completely abandon it?
The First Order is only tracking us from one destroyer. The lead one.
So we blow that one up.
I like where your head's at, but no. Sneak on board. Disable the tracker. Our fleet escapes before they realize.
How do we sneak the two of you onto Snoke's destroyer?
Vinny, are you saying the new trilogy is a mess? No.
The master codebreaker. You will find him with a red plum bloom on his lapel. In the casino.
Anal sphinx!
Oh, sorry.
Fuel left. We gotta hurry.
I'll be here to jump us to light speed.
Cantobite. On Cantonica.
Great! You know where that is?
Yeah. Grab a pod from the tank.
You're not gonna zap me this time, right?
I'm not ready to joke about that.
Get well soon. Travel to Cantobite and find the Master Codebreaker. Oh, you mean the dude that slithers and speaks like a snake? Do you remember in Canto Bight, there was one scene with the short alien lady with the eight tits? And she goes, "Aah!" It's like a 1.5 second scene, maybe 2 seconds at most. It was just a tit alien. I think that alien, like, only exists to provide num-nums. And that's it. It evolved to create num-nums. That rings a bell, says a chat member. No, it's real! It's real. It was a very real character in that film, in the casino scene.
You sure we can park here?
Don't get distracted. Remember, Master Codebreaker will be wearing a red plum bloom.
Sounds
sandcastles.
Like the kind of guy who'd hang out in that fancy building up there.
Show up to New Planet, break everything. It's the Lego way. Why are there 50 moons in the sky? You mean two? But, you know, 50.
The moon is right.
Maybe that was like 50 of them. That's no moon. there are good things about this movie. Like I said, some of the cinematography is nice. The fact that it is trying to say something about not having to have famous parents so that you could be your own person, which was later pulped in the next movie. But that, and also some of the music was good. What else was good? I was going to say, at least there's some interesting looking planets. There's, what else? There's no Death Star. Loopa loopa lula, lula lula loo. Every, like, 2 seconds you're stopped with a new thing. And you're like, I kinda wanna do that cool thing. Do this thing, switch to this character, get this item. And then, sooner or later, you have 400 hours in this game, and none of it is story.
Unless you're a
Mama the Hutt.
I ain't got time for you.
Why Boba no Fett? What is this? Why are these buttons weird?
I came to this seedy little town looking for the good for nothing hose nose that took my poor son Zero from me. But somehow, Sice Noodles is
always Sice Noodles.
One step ahead. In the event that you're slow on the uptake, this is where you come in. If you'd be willing to help me find that talentless lump, I'm sure I can make it worth your while.
Yeah, why is he sexy speak?
Then it's a deal. Last I heard, Sice Snoodles was trawling the streets of Kanto by trying to score a gig. Fancies herself a singer, you see. Go ask if the locals have seen or heard anything.
I wanted to find that little Ewok song where he goes, Looka, looka, lula. Someone said this is my workout song.
This place is so much fun. We have nothing like it on my home planet.
I don't even want to go to the private party.
Yeah, glitch.
A Red Plum Bloom? I mean, that's so last cycle. It's a crime that he thinks he looks good with it.
Hey! Tried to talk my way into the Codebreaker's private party, but I couldn't understand a word the guard said. A Twi'lek, I think. Big guard with a head tentacle. Hey!
Good. FYI, you're not doing the side mission for Mama. Oh, I wasn't planning on it. I just wanted to get more dialogue out of her. The casino scene is cringe cope. Oh
the
man.
Cope-breaker.
The cope breaker!
Yep, those are the shuttle parkers.
All right, you two are under arrest for parking violation 2017.
Without a codebreaker to sneak into Snoke's Star Destroyer, what do we do?
I don't know. Unless you got a thief in your pocket.
I can do it.
What?
Me and the First Order codage. Go way back.
Oh, it's that fucking thing. It's the tool to remove Legos that are incorrect.
Did he just...
I enjoyed that.
There. If we can get that cover up, we can escape through the sewer.
But we don't have our grapples.
We're gonna have to get them back from the guard room.
The alarm. If we set it off, the guards will have to come investigate.
That'll draw them out their room for sure.
Hey!
Yeah, right around on a gonk.
Let us out.
We set off the alarm. That'll definitely distract those guards.
That's some pretty gonk brain shit you got there, Chum.
Something around here should be able to weigh the switch down. Any ideas?
Oh yeah, I've got an idea.
We should set off that alarm soon if we're gonna lure those guards out.
You know, you remind me a lot of myself when I was younger. Minus the impressive cock.
Now, let's get to that guard room.
That was a chat member request. I didn't just pull that out of my ass.
Oceans can grow limbs back anyway, so what's the problem?
Okay, it's in here somewhere.
Are they maintenance guys?
They're prisoners, you moot milker! Call for backup now!
Great. Looks like our stuff is locked behind that force field.
We just need to disable that power generator.
Just gotta kill everyone. Effective prison guards. We are, like, continuing this shit. Meanwhile, the blue tit milk awaits. The game knows.
Destroy it?
Whatever gets us our stuff back.
It knows.
Well, that definitely worked.
Isn't it green?
Look.
It's greenish. I guess we'll find out. Luke likes blue milk in general. Like, that's the meme, is that he likes blue milk. So, if it's green, I don't remember 100%, but it might be. It's in the same family. It's like aqua blue. Aqua farms. It's just milk fresh. It just arrived. A whole bunch of new crimes said that.
Get him.
Vinny, did you learn to mix color? Didn't you learn to mix colors recently? Correctly. Yeah. Yeah, I learned how to stop a meteorite from striking the planet as well.
Those cops will be here any minute. What now?
And then there's this.
We're with the resistance.
And then there's this. As dumb as this is, at least it's not animals on the side of a Star Destroyer. Sir, they're not using technology. They're riding space horses! Tilt the Star Destroyer 45 degrees. Oh my god.
Shouldn't you have a little more respect for a Jedi weapon?
Master Skywalker?
I can't wait for Luke to morb. I like this person. Hello. What are you? What are you? I'm an idiot sandwich chef. Porg appeared out of nowhere.
I'm from the Resistance. Your sister Leia sent me. We need your help. Hello? I'm not taking no for an answer. We'll have to find a way in there.
Leave me alone.
Hello, I'm in your house now.
Please stop following me.
Look, it's... See? Blue milk. He's got blue milk cartons. This reminds me of Assassin's Creed a little bit. Anyone else? Like, climbing the buildings and stuff?
Look, the Resistance have sent me.
No?
Whatever you
it reminds
say,
me... Oh, I'm sorry. Character Assassin's Creed.
Skywalker.
Are you always this annoying?
I don't know.
Meanwhile, I think that what they did with Luke could have been very interesting if it was done right. I don't think it was done right. That's my opinion. I'm sure you've heard that opinion 10,000 times on the internet. Why do you need me to say it again? But that was the core of what Johnson was going for, was the Jedi were dogmatic and stubborn and, you know, it led to Anakin Skywalker and then Darth Vader because they didn't do the right thing and they were you couldn't have the sex and blah 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 and I thought that was like oh that's a cool thing to bring the prequels into it in an interesting way, but it just got real lame. And then whatever character development or work was done on Luke in this movie was then undone in Rise of Skywalker, because he's just back to being, like, Jedi Luke again. I don't know, man. I don't know, man. Sorry. It's Morbin time. My name is Luke Morbius, and I am from Och 2.
Why won't you hear what
a
I
planet
have to say?
Made from an actual sneeze. Like a, nice a god kid, sneezed.
But I'm not interested.
And I am dying. The only way to survive is blue tit milk. And I need to do that so that I can dance like my friend Matt Smith, who has a weird head. Weird head. Weird head. Matt Smith.
Master Skywalker.
Dance
about
scene.
The First Order. I know you can hear me!
Don't insult Matt Smith. I know, he was the best part of the movie from what I understand. And I do like Matt Smith. Just in that scene, well, the dancing scene that that's the only scene I've seen from Morbius. It is so weird. Like, they're trying to do this sexy dance. And there are things that Matt Smith does really well. And he did a good job in the sexy dance. I'll give him credit. But it was so fucking weird to look at. Maybe he's not the guy you want doing the sexy dance, is my point. But I like when they're doing that and then they become like vampire men and like screech into the camera. So fucking lame. Joel streamed the movie for 18 hours. Yeah, I need to have a talk with him. It's a very important scene. I couldn't have understood the movie unless it was that scene. Unless that scene was there. Well, you have to wonder, like, does this Morbius movie have enough shittiness in it that it becomes like a Neil Breen movie or a Troll 2? Or is it just funny because we've all made Morb memes? Like, I don't know. Apparently, it's, like, really mediocre. It's just extremely mediocre and extremely forced memeage. The memes are funnier than the movie. Man, that's a shame. I really want to give Neil Breen the budget of a Marvel movie and just, like, set him loose. And just see what he can create. Man, I would love that.
It's important, please.
Listen, kid. What's your name?
Ray.
Where are you from, Ray?
Nowhere.
No one's from nowhere.
Jakku.
All right, that is pretty much nowhere. Maybe you should go back to nowhere.
Are we there yet? The fuck? Oh, he was afraid. He heard the blaster. I thought he was crying.
Look, if you insist on following me, why don't you make yourself useful? I've lost my milk bottle. Go find it and bring it back to me.
There it is! That was it! That was the alien! That's it! That's the one! Those are its memories. I remember when this movie first came out, and I explained that there was blue titty milk, and that Link guzzled it straight from the nipple. Which I don't think he did, but anyway, I was talking about it, and people thought I was joking. They thought, like, Vinny's just... Did I call him Link? Link Skywalker. Whoa, where was that? Luke. When Luke drank the milk and I talked about it, there were people that thought I was joking and being my usual stupid self and inserting a fake scene into the movie just for like a cheap laugh. And then they saw the movie, and then, like, for, like, a good solid 2 weeks, people were joining my chat and being like, Vinny, I thought you were lying. Holy shit, there was a blue titty milk scene. I like how they're dragging this out even further. They know damn well how much we want that milk. Also, in the new Red Letter Media video, they talked about Star Wars. Like, where's the Yaddle show? I always thought it was pronounced Yaddle, but sure. And, they invented a hashtag. What was it? justice for Yaddle. So I thought it was interesting. I just unlocked Yaddle. And now Yaddle is gonna get a show.
Thanks, kid. Don't think this means I owe you anything, though.
Oh my god. All the, there's milk pumping. There's like devices. There's multiple ones. That was even worse than just taking it straight from the nipple. Also, it's green. It's like a blue-green, yes. Alright, I'm done. That's the end of the...
I know this place.
Lego Star Wars streams.
The original Jedi texts. Why are you here?
Something inside me has always been there. I need someone to show me my place in all this.
Jar Jar.
No. Three lessons. I will teach you the ways of the Jedi and why they need to end.
All right, fine. We'll do a little bit more. It's Porgin time. Yes, a little bit more and then I'll check out. The Doom thing is not particularly long. There's not a lot of it, but I'm also not planning on streaming until like 1:30 tonight, so. I just don't know how much more of this game I wish to play in regards to, like, The Last Jedi versus... Do I want to play... Because there's, like, the Ben Solo stuff, that's fun. But do I want to see Rise of Skywalker, like... That chat member was baiting me into it. Saying that it was funny. It's like, well, I definitely got my money's worth out of this game and I've enjoyed it. Vinny, your suffering gets you views. I guess that's true. Why wouldn't you want to play a game that's making fun of things you hate? Well, hate's a strong word. You know. But you have a good point.
Are you ready to start your training?
Suffering leads to
pain leads to suffering. Suffering leads to ad revenue. Ad revenue leads to hate. Hate leads to cock. Cock leads to ass. And then... crush!
Sit down. Reach out. Breathe. What do you see?
The island.
I should have said cock leads to rock. You are correct.
The island. A dark place.
It's calling me.
Resist it. You went straight to the dark.
That cave. I need to see what's inside.
I feel like they could have... I don't know what they could have done with Rey that would have been unique. Because they had... Oh, there's another one. They had Anakin fall to the dark side. Then they had Anakin go to the light side. Like, they definitely toyed with the idea of Rey going over to the dark side, but not enough. not rewrite her arc 3 times, yeah. Oh, well. Gray Jedi. That was what I was hoping. The Rise of Skywalker, I was hoping that the word Skywalker was going to be the title of a Jedi. I know it sounds lame, but hear me out. Like, if her and Kylo decided to take on, like, if Snoke didn't die in this movie and was like the big bad, and the Knights of Ren and Snoke were the big bads of the third movie, and Kylo Ren and Rey had to team up, maybe not as light side or dark side, but like somewhere in the middle, and they helped each other achieve that, that would have made the Reylo shit actually make sense. And it would have led to a more interesting discussion about the nature of, like, balance, which is what I thought this movie was going for. But Rian Johnson was like, well, if we killed Snoke in this movie, it would be real cool subversion of expectations. It would be really shocking moment. It would be really cool to see that happen. Was it, though? It looked cool, but then they didn't know what the fuck to do for the third movie, because they lost their villains. And Kylo, they wouldn't let Kylo be the primary villain, because then the people that want them to kiss would be unhappy. That was the original script. Colin Trevorrow wrote Kylo as the original, like, big bad of episode 9. And then Disney was like, nah. But yes, this is cool. This is what a nice, well-done thing right here. It's a way to do the psychedelic shit from that cave, but also have it be gameplay. It's awesome. Him being obsessed with Force artifacts and being main villains also need scrap concept. Force Awakens, I wish got more exposure. Yeah.
You'll bring Luke Skywalker to me.
Oh yeah, Matt Smith was originally in episode 9.
You're gonna pay for what you did.
I can't see yours.
You're too late. You lost. I found Skywalker.
Did he tell you what happened? The night I destroyed his temple, he had sensed my power. As he senses yours. And he feared him. You're not alone.
Neither are you.
Stop!
Poor Chewie.
Is it true? Did you create Kylo Ren?
Leave this island now!
Oh, I gotta fight Luke.
Did you do it? Luke, I need to know. What happened?
I thought I could train him. I could pass on my strengths. Snoke had already turned his heart. And he turned on me.
If I go to him, Ben Solo will turn.
Rey, don't do this.
Then he is our last hope.
I'm all of this.
Solo, you did. Lose Rey? We must not.
I have to talk to Ben.
C-
Cock leads to rock.
I know there's still good in him.
Rock leads to pain.
I know, Chief.
Pain leads to suffering. Suffering leads to strength.
Oh, wow, Yoda, when you put it like that, it makes a whole lot more sense.
Complete your training, I will.
But Yoda, I don't have one of those elements that is required for this.
Find a way, we will!
I'm leaving. I gotta say that emote. Thank you, chat member, for giving me that animated Lego stud emote. I enjoy it very much. And it has multiple purposes. You could use it whenever I'm collecting large quantities of whatever the fuck. No Snoke without fire, yeah. Well, Palpatine, like his, you know, heart palpitations, Sidious, insidious. Snoke, smoke. He's a smokescreen for Palpatine, who is behind it. It's all connected.
You don't have to do this. I feel the conflict in you. It's tearing you apart.
My conscience is clear.
My chest is wide.
You still hurt. I feel it.
You still hurt.
Hey! I'm playing as Kylo Ren.
Let me get that for you, Mr. Kylo, sir.
My name is Matt. I'm a technician here on the Death Star. Oh, wait, this isn't a Death Star. What is your ranking of all the Star Wars movies? I think I did that a while back. Fuck, I was reading chat. Well, it's Empire, A New Hope.
What are we doing here?
Jedi.
An impromptu health inspection.
They have you doing all these.
And then I don't really care after that. Whatever, you can, you know. I just know that I hate Episode 2. I hate Episode 9. And there you go. That's my rankings. Well, again, I can't help but at least give 8 some bonus points for what I mentioned earlier. It's on the lower end of the tier list for sure. And Episode 1 is just hilarious to me. Like, I just love making fun of that movie. I love watching the silliness.
We're meeting the Supreme Leader. I dressed appropriately.
But communicating through the Force, that calls for being shirtless?
It caught me by surprise. Enough of this. The Supreme Leader is waiting for us.
I bet he has his shirt on.
I'm sorry, who are we talking to? Left, left, right, down. Does 1/3 of the puzzle and then leaves. I gave up. I thought about it for a minute. I was like, I could continue trying to do this puzzle, but Kylo Ren is moving awful slow. Oh, hey, where'd you come from? Kylo Ren would not like the achievement he just got. True Jedi. Yeah, me neither. Or maybe, like, go into light speed for, like, a millisecond to get just ahead of them.
Must you comment on everything we do?
I will solve this puzzle because now I am motivated. It's a cool one. The camera gets real scummy real quick. Like, I didn't even mean to do that. Just...
Powers, pal. How about you show some respect for a little thing called manual labor? Why won't it just work?
Big old battleships, bad wiring. Wired by a Jawa.
Clearance, please.
My lord, my sincerest apologies. Proceed as you wish.
Then, when we touched hands, I saw your future. Just the shape of it. You will not bow before Snoke. In turn, I'll help you.
I saw something too. Because of what I saw, I know when the moment comes, you will be the one to turn. You will stand with me, Rey.
Incompetent maintenance staff. I told them to have this fixed.
Join me and let's fix it.
I see what you're doing. How about you join me and we fix it?
Can we just fix it together?
Fine. But you will join me. I saw it.
Whatever. Cool kitchen. Kylo sounds like Rev and it's bugging the fuck out of me. A little bit, maybe. Kylo Rev.
You can explain to the Supreme Leader why you destroyed our kingdom.
How was that my fault?
I remember the scene in episode 8 where Rey fucking went rampage nuts inside of a kitchen. Why did this part need to be in the game? Agreed! But whatever. You just walk and then you get there and then you then Snoke and stuff.
Come closer, child.
You don't remember the scene where Rey trashed a kitchen?
And Ben Solo. Uh-huh. And me.
You have the spirit of a true Jedi. My worthy apprentice, son of darkness, heir apparent to Lord Vader, fulfill your destiny.
I know what I have to do.
I was wondering how they were going to handle that murder. But, you know, with Lego, it's easy. It's the two halves. This scene looked cool. And I still think it is a cool looking scene with, like, you know, the set is nice and the flames look awesome. The problem is that when you start to look at the scene, it's just a bunch of guys like in a video game, like what they're doing right now. And like the stunt actors maybe couldn't see through the helmets and there's a lot of like swinging at nothing. Like, things disappear, there's a lot of weird misses, like, a lot of these guards have the chance to actually attack and kill one of them, but they just don't because it's movie. But, you know, it's a movie, as Han Solo once said. Yeah, they wait for the other actor to take their turn, that happens a lot. I still don't think it's as bad as some people make it out to be. Like, the actual set of this scene is cool, and some of the fighting looks cool, like the weird weapons they have.
Get ready.
That's fine. This is fine.
But after this scene was where, when I was watching the movie, I was like, man, they really should join. And the cliffhanger of the movie should be, like, this is just my opinion, I'm a dumbass, but I thought it would have been cool if the cliffhanger was him reaching out his hand and she, like, grabs the hand and then it cuts away from them. And then, you know, the next movie is what that maybe ends up being. But, like I said, I thought maybe it would have been cool to have them take down the First Order together and then try to start, like, the Grey Jedi thing or something. I don't know. It just, whatever ended up happening after this was ultimately way less interesting for me. Keep in mind, a few space days ago, both Rey and Kylo were just barely training the Force, and now they're going up against the Space Guard. Kylo was more trained. A thing I find interesting is this game, the movies, episode 7 and 8 take place, you are right, it's just a few space days. And then the gap between 8 and 9 is like a year. So this is a lot of shit that went down in just a couple days.
Oh.
Are you fighting your guards? Oh, they're dead. I'm just looking for Lego stuff now. Also, disclaimer, for people that absolutely love these movies, as I've said before, there's going to be a generation of kids that grew up with these, and they're going to be making video essays in 15 years saying how the sequels are secretly genius. Maybe. Maybe not. But there will be some people that remember these things fondly. But if you enjoy them, don't let me and other internet cynics take that away from you. Please. Same for every opinion that any internet dumbass like myself has. Just enjoy what you enjoy.
I want you to join me. We can rule together.
I know I don't have to say that, but I feel like it's something I kind of should say.
Well, we found a code breaker.
You can actually do this, right?
Cloaking our approach, we should be off their scopes.
Okay. I do think that'll be enough of this for today.
Sure they can't see us?
We'll be fine. And if not, we won't have to worry about it.
I'm gonna check out that other thing. It's like you're not enjoying this or something. I am. It's just a lot of me bitching about the sequels, which is ultimately in my control and my own fault. But, you know, I'm still enjoying it. I'm enjoying talking about it. I'm enjoying playing through it and having the game make fun of it. That is definitely something that is correct. But, you know, I'm good for now. I've been playing it for like an hour, 2 hours and 20 minutes. So I am good. But I'm gonna think about it. Do me a favor. If you want to see more of this, leave a comment. Leave a comment on the YouTube video version of this. And if you, you know, because I mean, listen, chat members, I know you're here live right now, but I actually want to read some of the comments that aren't scrolling up at 4,000 miles an hour. Something that I can sit back and say, all right, well, chat members want me to play more of this. I just, the plan was to see the blue tit milk and stop. It wasn't the best plan, but it was a plan nonetheless. But if you want to see more of this and then go through episode 9, I could probably do that as long as I just don't do the side quests. So, but thank you very much for listening to me rant. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. And I hope you enjoyed either the Legos, the Star Wars, or my stupid commentary. We will quit to main menu now. And I'm going to take a quick break, and I'll be back with this dooming the bar City 17 thing.
I need some. Be sure to like, subscribe, leave a comment.
Fear leads to cock. Cock leads to rock. Rock leads to pain. Pain leads to pain. Pain leads to pain. Pain leads to pain. Pain leads to pain.
I'll be right back, everybody.